welcome to the one more video session. This is Vasant Nayak from Canara Engineering College. In this video session, we will discuss introduction to ARM instruction set. So before moving to the introduction session of ARM instruction set, let us first discuss the various conditional instructions. Let us first go through various conditional instructions. Within a couple of minutes, you will come to know what is the use of this one. First here, you can see some of the conditional instructions. Branch always, BAL, branch never, BNV. This is like no operation in case of Intel processor. Branch if carry is set, branch if carry is clear, branch if overflow is set. If there is an overflow, then it will move to the particular section. Then it will jump to the particular section. Particular instruction, otherwise it will skip that instruction. Branch if overflow is clear. Branch minus. Branch minus means if the result of a previous operation is negative, then branch plus, branch equal, branch not equal. These are the sum of the instructions. Similarly, branch higher. If you are going to compare two numbers, if one number is higher than the other, branch higher. Branch higher or same. Branch lower or branch lower or same, branch greater or equal, branch less than or equal. So these two set of instructions are actually, if I say these two set of instructions are same, but one is for unsigned number, one is for signed number. One is for unsigned number, one is for signed number. That is the difference. So now we will see why I told you all these instructions. Let us first see. Let me take one instruction first. The first instruction is like, I will write here, move R0, R1. What is the meaning of this one? So here R1 is moved to R0. So everyone knows this one, R1 is moved to R0. So from the exam point of view, you cannot expect this type of questions. Instead of this one, let me write equation in some other form. Move EQ R0, R1. So this equation looks somewhat complicated. Now you have to first see the core of the instruction. Core of the instruction is move. So move R1 is moved to R0. When the previous operation, don't consider the current operation. Current operation, R1, if you move R1, if R0 equal to R1, then R1 is moved to R0 is meaningless. Nonsense. In the previous operation, results in equal. Like you are going to compare two numbers, both numbers found equal in the previous operation, then particular flag will be activated, that time R1 is moved to R0. That is the meaning. So now we will take one more instruction here. MOVS moves R0, R1. What is the meaning of this one? Moves. So once again, you have to see core of the instruction. Core of the instruction is move. Then what is this S? Student, you need to understand, in Intel processor, any arithmetic or logical operation affect the flag register. But in ARM, if you don't add S to the instruction, it will not affect the status flag or flag register. So student, if I write move R0, R1, then it will move R1 to R0, but it will not affect the flag register. For example, if I use add R0, R1, then when you add R0, R1, if there is any carry, then it won't affect the flag register. In order to activate the flag register, you have to add all the instructions like S, then only it will affect the particular flag in the flag register. You need to remember this one. So similarly, I will take one more instruction, my dear student. So one more instruction is add EQ S So let me write in the other page. So let me take one more instruction, add EQ, sorry, add EQ S R0, R1. Now student, here, it looks some like complicated. If you see the instruction, it looks like complicated. What is this instruction? Like add EQ S. So first consider the core of the instruction. Core of the instruction is add. That means it will add two numbers, R0, R1. Okay. So let me write this instruction in the triadic way, triadic format. So add EQ S R0, R1, R2. So we know the you have to see here core of the instruction. Core of the instruction is add. Add means it will add here R1 plus R2 and result is stored in R0. That is, here R0 is nothing but R1 plus R2. Please remember, it is not going to add three registers. It will not add R0 plus R1 plus R2. So this is possible in C language and in on the book, but it is not possible in case of assembly language. Sorry, when you add two numbers in assembly language. Why? Because if you add two numbers, 9 plus 9, the result is 18. 8 is the sum and 1 is the carry. Good. If you add two biggest number, 99 and 99, 9 and 9, 8, 1, 8, 1 is the carry, 9 and 9, 8, 1, 9, 1, 9, 8, that is 1 is the carry. But suppose if you add 9, 9, 9, then this becomes a 27. 7 is the sum, carry is the 2, carry, a carry is 2. But in when you add a bit, the carry can be either 0 or 1. It can't be 2. That's why one book it is possible, or when you write some programs in C language it is possible, but in assembly language it is not possible. Like you cannot add 3 registers. So when I write R0, R1, R2, it mean like R0 is equal to R1 plus R2. R0 is equal to R1 plus R2. Then you may ask, what is the use of this one? Use of this one is, you may ask, what is the use of this one? We are wasting one more register. It is not exactly like we are wasting one more register. It is not like exactly we are wasting one more register. So here you see, suppose if I write the instruction, add R0, R0, R1, then it will add R0 plus R1 and result is stored in the R0. That means content of R0 is lost. So if you use the instruction in this way, then R1 will be added to R2 and the result is stored in R0. One more register. Result is stored in one more register. That is the advantage. So student, when you see this instruction, you have to first see the core of the instruction. Core of the instruction is add EQ. Yes, try to divide the instruction here. First one is add. So by means of add, that is nothing but adding two register and storing the result in R0. Then EQ, what is EQ? If the previous operation results in equal, that is, you are going to compare two numbers in the previous operation and which results in equal, something like that, then it will add R1 and R2 and the result is stored in R0. Otherwise, it will skip this instruction. This is the example for branch instruction. My dear students, try to understand. This is the example for branch instruction. Now, what is this S? As I told, if you don't add S, then it won't affect the flag register. So, in order to affect the flag register, what you have to do? You have to add S to all the instruction. Almost all instruction except some few instruction you can add S. So the purpose of adding S means this operation will affect the flag register. So this is the meaning of add EQS R0, R1, R2. Let me repeat, it will add R1 plus R2 and result is stored in R0 only when previous operation results in equal, and once after adding, it will affect the flag register also. That is because we have added S to the instruction. That is the meaning of add EQS. So with this, students, I will conclude this video, and in the next video we will continue the instruction set of ARM.